That's it. So we are talking about above principle. Now just draw this. Now above principle says that electron will occupy, above principle say, electron will occupy the orbital having lower n plus n value. Lower n plus n value.
Okay.
So what is n? Okay, I tell you. Principal quantum number. And what are the values? 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5. Principal quantum number. Is this clear? What are the values of principal quantum number and possible values of n? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. Let's talk about the azimuthal quantum number. Azimuthal quantum number, okay, L. For s orbital, the azimuthal quantum number has value 0. For p orbital, azimuthal quantum number has value 1. For t orbital, azimuthal quantum number value is 2. And for f, it is. Write it down. Azimuthal quantum number values for s, p, d, and f orbitals. Okay. Is this clear? Okay, now let's see one. And this is called as L plus L room. That is also called as above principle building up. The energy electron will occupy the lower energy orbital flux, or the orbital whose n plus l value is lower. Is this understand? Okay. Now let's see n plus l value. Now, what is the n plus l value of s orbital in first shape? 1 plus 0, 1. Everything is in front of you. Okay. Then let's compare these two. Now, how many electron capacity of orbital maximum? 2. So 2 electrons will occupy 1 s orbital. Let's take example. Okay. So let's take example of sodium. Atomic number?
11.
Now we should place 11 electrons in different orbit and orbitals according to the energy. Now out of 11, first electron that will go into 1s orbit, but its capacity is of 2 electrons. So 2 electrons out of 11 electrons will be occupied in 1s orbit. So I'll write down 1s2. How many electrons are left now?
9.
So first 2 electrons go into 9. Out of 9, now what is the maximum capacity of second shell? 8. Right? You know that rule? What is that rule? 2n square. Simple. Have you heard that? 2n square rule. So maximum capacity is at 8 electrons. So 8 electrons will be occupied in second shell. But in second shell, there are 4 orbitals now. How can be 4 orbitals? 1s, and there are 3 types of p orbitals. Px, py, and pz. So how many orbitals now? 4. And each orbital has maximum capacity of 4 2s. Now, the first two electrons will occupy one 2s orbitals, 2s2. Now, I want n plus a values of these two orbitals, 2p and 3s. Both are having same n plus l values. Check it out. N plus l value. L for p orbital is how much? 1. So it is 2 plus 1, 3. N plus n for 3s orbital, 3 plus 0, because l value of s orbital is 0. So which is the lower energy orbital? Lower energy orbital is that one whose principal quantum number is less. So incoming electron will occupy 2p orbital first, and then they will go to 3s orbitals. Is this clear? N plus n rule. Okay. So let's start about 2p6, because px, ui and pz. Right? Okay. So, in the p orbitals, there are 3 orbitals. Px, py, pz. 2 electrons each. So, these are 6 electrons. And each electron is having different spin. And now that orientation, we are talking about L. Px, y, pz. So it will be value of L, 0 plus M minus L. How? One will be along x axis, one will be along y axis, and one will be along z axis. So, magnetic quantum number gives the direction. Either along x axis, y axis, or z axis. Is this clear? And spin quantum number clockwise, anti-clockwise. Clockwise, anti-clockwise. Is this clear? Next, how many electrons are left now? One electron only. The next electron will go to 3s orbital. This electron is configuration of sodium. So if you know this figure, you draw this figure. You can draw electronic configuration of any element, provided that you know the atomic number. Okay, let's start about chlorine then. Electronic configuration of chlorine. Okay. Now you tell me the electronic configuration. You all try electronic configuration, drawing the how you can try electronic configuration of chlorine. Just follow this figure. You have to accommodate 17 electrons in different orbit and orbitals. You try first 2 electrons, 1s2, followed then, just remember this figure is infinitely. Next, 2s2. Then 2p, how many electrons maximum? In p orbitals? 6. Followed by? Okay. 3 electrons, with clockwise spin. I'm talking about these 5 electrons. Rest of the 2 electrons, they will pair up and 1 electron will remain unpaired. In case of sodium, there is 1 unpaired electron in 3s4 particles. So the driving force, somebody told me, when they think about chemistry, they think about compounds. So let's talk about the compounds then. In formation of compounds, the 2 atoms come together, 2 or more atoms come together and they form compounds. What is the driving force behind that? We all are aware of the compound NaCl, it's an ionic one. Do you agree? Ionic one. Now why it is ionic? If I ask you, the answer lies in the electronic configuration. So, sodium, third shape. Now you all are aware of the rule N, 2N square rule. The maximum capacity of third shape is 18 electrons. So instead of accepting 17 electrons, sodium prefers to go that 1 electron and get the electronic configuration of nearest noble gas. Okay? And in that case, okay, it is argon 10, neon 10, okay, argon is 18. Same case is chlorine, it has got 1 electron short to get the electronic configuration of argon 18. So, the electron which is donated by sodium will be accepted by chlorine. So sodium donates 1 electron and it converts into sodium ion, cation, and chlorine accepts that electron and gets converted into chloride, anion, and there is electrostatic force of attraction between oppositely charged ions, and that is nothing but the ionic bond. We get this. Are you getting electronic configuration and the driving force behind formation of ionic bond? Okay. That. I'll take example. Okay. Now, for example, let's take example of iron. What is the atomic number of iron? Don't you have periodic table in your book? Okay, iron is 26, cobalt 27, nickel 28, zinc 29. Okay, so what is iron? Fe 26, right? Nickel 28. How much? Cobalt 27, correct? Okay, how about zinc? So you tell me the electronic configuration of zinc. Can you write down the electronic configuration of zinc by using this above principle? Write it down. That's it. You can do it. Return the electronic configuration of aluminium.
Pure batteries, there are three types of pure batteries.
they will be placed like this. On electrons, they will be having clockwise spin, three electrons. But when we are talking about oxygen, 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Now, in that case, in pure matrix, first three electrons will be placed in all the three. Next, fourth electron, then it will pair up and with anti-clockwise spin. Is this clear? Let's consider Pauli's exclusive principle. Now, Pauli, there was a scientist who stated this principle. According to him, each electron is exclusive. What do you mean by exclusive? Yes, it is unique. According to his principle, no two electrons have same set of quantum numbers. Each electron is unique. For example, I'll give you an example. In your classroom, suppose there are two Sachin present, but their surname has to be different. One is Joshi, other one is Kelkar. If at all, both are Joshi, definitely their middle name has to be different. We agree with you. So such a way, each electron is having all the four quantum numbers different. It will not have same set of four quantum numbers. Let's consider these two electrons now. These electrons, suppose this is px, this is py, this is pz. I am talking about L, then L, then L, and then S. Let's talk about, this is the A electron, this is B electron, A, B. Now both are present in principal quantum number, second shape. So it is 2 for them. L, what is the value of L? Yeah. One. Then M, if it is, this is 0, this is minus 1, plus 1, both are having either minus 1 or plus 1. That is plus 1, plus 1. Our test is quantum number. One is having clockwise, the other one is having. So plus half, minus 1. Are these four numbers set? They are same. No. So each electron is exclusive. No two electrons will have set of four quantum. Which one? This one? If you have understood what are quantum numbers, then you will understand. Suppose if I want to identify a student in the classroom, I must have its first name, middle name, surname. I give you the example. So, if two students there having same first name, Sachin, Sachin, their surname has to be different. One is Joshi, the other one is Kelkar. Suppose, their surname is also same. Both are Sachin, Joshi, Sachin, Joshi. Their middle name has to be different. Yes or no? I will still go further. If their middle name is same, definitely their addresses has to be different. So these two, they are individual. Okay. So just like that, no two electrons, they are same in the atom. Why? Because of they are having different set of quantum numbers. This one, they are placed in electron in different fashion. It is called as Pauli's exclusive. So, we will do the example of these two electrons. How they are different? quantum number, same shape, same shape, same type of form factor. Again, their direction is same along x axis, but one is moving clockwise, another one is moving. So each electron is unique. Is this clear? So you get the so many things we discussed today. And if you understand this, you will understand the chemistry very easy. So then you understand the elements which are present in S block, they are called as alkali metals and alkaline earth metals. Why they are called as metals? Because they are electro positive. Means they will donate electrons. Why they will donate electron? Because of their electronic configuration. Their electronic configuration is such that, for example, sodium, instead of accepting 17 electrons, it's better to donate one electron and acquire the nearest inner gas configuration. So driving force behind the donation of electron is to acquire stability. And that electron is accepted by chlorine. So P block elements are electronegative. Why called as electronegative? Because they have a tendency to accept electrons. Electropositive, you say that I am positive about something. I am positive about donating money. Means I have a surplus money, so I can donate it. I am willing to donate. So electropositive means they are willing to donate electrons. Electronegative, I am negative about it. I am not going to donate. On the contrary, I am accepting. Are you getting it? So again, when you come for the periodic table, we have got S block elements. Why they are called S block elements? Because their valence electrons are present in S orbital. P block, valence electron present in D block, chromium, and F orbital. So they are electropositive, they are electro metals, all metals. In between, the elements, they have got both the characteristics. You can donate as well as accept. So going from electropositive to electronegative, there is a transition. That's why they are called as transition elements. Are you getting my point? Have you understood the periodic table? Have you understood the electronic configuration? And based on the electronic configuration, you can predict the properties of elements, whether it is electropositive or electronegative. These elements, now depending upon their electronic configuration, where they will find, they will form ionic bond, or a covalent bond, or a coordinate bond. There are different types of bonds. Have you studied this? We will study about these bonds next. Homework for you. Electronic configuration. Try to write down the electronic configuration of any of the element. Take a periodic table in front of you. Okay? And write down the electronic configuration by using this figure of Bohm principle. And then you come to know about the where, in which orbital the valence electrons are present. And depending upon the electronic configuration, where is the valency of that element? Whether it will donate the electron, how many? So it is plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4. Okay, and then we will talk about the valency of the electrons, elements. We will talk about the types of bonds. We will talk about ionic compounds. We will talk about covalent compounds, we will talk about coordinate bonds, coordinate compounds, and based on that, we will come to know about the properties of different metals, non-metals, different elements. We will talk about the theories of bonding, okay, valence bond theory, okay, theory of hybridization. Have you heard about that? And after that, we will talk about the shape of the molecules. know the shape of the orbitals, you will know about the shape of the molecules. Okay? This is the basis of chemistry. Nobody teaches you the basis of chemistry, basic fundamentals. How you can understand chemistry? Understand if you understand the element first, atom first, electronic configuration first, and then we talk about what sort of bonds. Whether it is ionic, covalent, or coordinate. Why a particular molecule is ionic? Why a particular molecule is non-polar? Why a particular molecule is polar one? If I give you the example, water is a polar solvent. On the contrary, petrol is non-polar. Why petrol doesn't mix with water? You have a reason from chemistry point of view? Same is going to be asked in MTS. Know this. Thing is that they are very simple.